First chapter is a very, very important chapter because it has prepared our consciousness now. We need to overcome this insecurity of comparison born out of ignorance, like what Dhritarashtra has demonstrated. We need to overcome this insecurity of being critical, which is born out of the rajasic nature of Duryodhan. And we also need to overcome this pitfall. You know, the first and second insecurities are kind of easy because when you are a victim of these insecurities, at least you know that you have a problem. When you're constantly comparing with others or when you're criticizing others, at least deep down, you know that you have a problem. But when you are overwhelmed by this sattvic insecurity, sometimes you don't even know that there is a problem, right? So of course, to recognize the problem is half the problem solved. Right, to recognize a problem as a problem is half the problem solved. But the point is, at least learn to recognize the problem. If you identify the problem and acknowledge the problem, the solution will start, the medicine will start taking its effect. Right, and then we also saw these five very powerful arguments Arjuna gives why not to fight. First argument, he says, a sense of false compassion. I don't want to kill my relatives. I want to be compassionate to them. Second, he says, it's I have nothing to gain out of it. If I win, I can't share my enjoyment with my relatives because I'll have to kill them. If I lose, I lose my own life. So it's loss and loss. There's no enjoyment coming out of this war. Third, I don't want to commit any sinful reactions by killing these people. Fourth, that very powerful argument, if I kill these people, gradually entire social structure is going to break down and there's going to be such major havoc in the society because a complete destruction of family traditions and social traditions is going to take place because of this war. And finally, despite all these arguments, Arjuna was still confused and he was indecisive. Should I or should I not fight? So these are the five important arguments of Arjuna. The second chapter which Krishna is going to speak, Krishna is going to systematically answer these questions step by step way, like how an expert lawyer completely decimates the arguments of the opposition. Krishna, again, sticking to the Vedic path, sticking to the teachings of the Vedas, he is going to completely decimate each of these arguments presented by Arjuna and give the right perspective and show what is the right way to look at this particular situation. So make sure you have these 5 points always in your head, because like I said, the Gita is a conversation. You know, imagine you're watching a movie. You can't jump into a movie after the 30 minutes mark. If you miss the first 30 minutes, you can't just jump in. You don't even know who's who and what is happening there. So these, if you forget what has happened in this chapter, the connection for the rest of the Gita will be lost. So make sure these 5 arguments are always there, because repeatedly every principle, every system of yoga Krishna is going to present, he is going to reference it to these arguments, just trying to present a way out of these false arguments that the false insecurities that Arjuna is voicing here. So please note that down. And so these are the main themes from our first chapter.